Yes, I've got some old man grey stubble going on the old noggin. Hey there, welcome to another video. Just a quick update today. You guys have made a few comments on some previous videos just asking how I'm going, and I haven't made an update video on my cancer journey since before Christmas, so I thought I'd give you a quick update today on my cancer and chemotherapy journey. But first, if you're new, just the backstory. In March 2019, I was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. Doctors are pretty sure that I've got a cancerous growth on my pancreas. Shortly after, in April 2019, I had some pretty major surgery to try and remove the tumour from my pancreas, and that involved actually removing a third of my pancreas, a bit of bowel, some internal plumbing rearrangements, and I was then in hospital for a couple of months with some complications. But we thought we'd got it. Everything was looking good. I went on to 6 months of chemotherapy in 2019, up to Christmas of that year, just as a precaution. And then early 2020, everything was looking good. All my test results were looking like we might have beaten the cancer. But in August 2020, last year, the scans and the blood tests were showing that it had come back. We went for a PET scan, PET scan, which confirmed that there was growth, two new growths on my pancreas. And by that point, the cancer levels in my blood had skyrocketed as well. So I went back on to chemotherapy again, and that caused some side effects. I lost my hair, made a video about that, became a nude nut, and I started shaving just because I was just getting a very light sprinkling of grey stubble. But now I've decided to sort of let it go, see how we go, see what this grey stubble turns into. Another side effect from the chemotherapy was my fingernails. Feel like they've been hit with a hammer, and they've got, see, the bruising or bleeding under the nail. All my fingers, except that one, have got this discolorization under the nail. Even the thumbs, if you can see that. Following on from that video, my fingernails actually became infected. I had to cut them really, really short just to try and stop the, it's not very nice, but I was getting some pus and blood underneath the nails. But a course of antibiotics has seemed to have fixed that, and I think they're coming good now. Now, the update. The chemotherapy did its job. My tumour has become a lot smaller, and the cancer markers in my blood tests have come down to a normal level, which is fantastic, and I'm doing a lot better than a lot of other people, so I'm very thankful. But the chemotherapy was making me really, really sick. The night after chemo and the next day, I wasn't very well. I was either throwing up or sleeping, especially the day after. I was spending a lot of the day just sleeping. So I had a checkup with the oncologist a few weeks ago, and we've decided to stop the chemotherapy for now. It was doing more harm than good. Like I said, it had done its job in reducing the tumour and bringing my blood tests back to normal, but it was just making me too sick, and every week I was getting sicker and sicker. So we've stopped the chemotherapy for now, and I'm feeling terrific. And that's part of the reason why I've let the grey stubble grow a bit. With the chemo stopped now, hopefully maybe I might get some thicker regrowth. We'll see what happens. But there is a downside. Even though the oncologists are happy with my progress, they're still saying that my time could be limited. They've done another form. So they're now saying most likely I've got less than 12 months left. They're hopeful that it could pan out a lot longer, and so am I, obviously, and I'm doing a lot better than a lot of other patients. So even though they're saying most likely it's less than 12 months, they're hopeful it might pan out to a couple of years. And I'm hopeful I can prove them totally wrong. So that's where we're up to. That diagnosis does mean that hopefully I can make a claim on my life insurance. Maybe we can get a bit of a payout, perhaps get a deposit together for a house, because this is just a rental. It would be nice to set the family up in our own place while I'm still around. Anyway, there you go. I thought I was going to have trouble keeping it together while I told you all that, but we've made it through. If there's any more updates, I'll make another video, another cancer chemotherapy update. But that's the story for now. Thanks for watching. I'm going to try and make some other videos along the way. I really enjoyed the previous video on the channel where I got the drone up and did some footage of a railway overpass progression. So if you're into that sort of thing, go back and look at that. I'm not sure what else I've got coming up, but I'll try and put some other videos out. And if there's an update on my health, I'll do another cancer journey update. But until then, I will see you in the next video. Cheers. Thanks for watching. Do the hand thing again. See ya.